dignity therapy is based around the idea, the notion of generativity, which is this whole idea that at end of life or towards a time of illness or with aging, do we reach a point in our existence where we begin to look at the influence that our life, our existence may have on those that we'll eventually leave behind? You know, that's generativity, the next generation. What do we do in this life that may have a ripple effect beyond even our existence? So dignity therapy was developed as a brief psychological intervention. It engages people in a conversation that allows them to speak to things that they hold dear, that they think are important, that they want known and said before this life is done. Those conversations are tape recorded and transcribed, and the transcript is then edited so that we can turn this meandering dialogue into this more pristine narrative for them to, in most instances, bequeath to a loved one, a family member. At this point, dignity therapy has been done in many different places worldwide. There are many different studies going on, accumulating evidence for the efficacy of dignity therapy. What we've learned through our experience is that everyone has a story. Intuitively, you might think dignity therapy is an intervention for people who have lived full and rich lives, who have incredible stories to tell so that they can leave them behind for others. What you learn is that everybody has a story. Some of them are incredible, some of them are tragic, some of them are funny, and usually they're a combination of all of those things. But the only person who's in a position to tell the story is that individual, because they are unique and they've lived the experience. And so that's what makes dignity therapy and the experience of doing dignity therapy, I think, so wonderful and engaging.